Hi, I'm Justin with Roland Pro AV, and welcome to this tutorial on the UVC-02 web presentation dock. The UVC-02 adds high quality video and audio to meetings and content creation by converting both video and audio to USB using a single device. No longer do you need a separate video capture and audio interface, and the UVC-02 adds audio mixing and audio effects to further enhance your setup. All you need is an HDMI camera and an XLR microphone, and your computer will see the UVC-02 as both a webcam and audio interface. In this video, we'll show you how to set up the UVC-02, go over what the knobs and buttons do, show you how the companion software works, along with tips for great results. First, let's install the companion software from the UVC-02 product page. There is a web link printed inside the box. Note that this is a special web link, so it is not roland.com, it is roland.cm. From there, scroll down a bit and click on Downloads, and then download the UVC-02 setup tool for your operating system. It's available for both Windows and Mac OS. Once downloaded, extract the folder from the zip file, and then run the installer inside the folder. Once installed, the software will not open until you connect the UVC-02 to your computer with the included USB cable. Additional accessories in this video are sold separately. But before we do that, let's first connect an HDMI camera. The UVC-02 supports HD video signals. Note that most cameras will output a compatible signal automatically. Next, we'll connect a microphone to the XLR input. For this video, I'll use a Roland CGM30 gooseneck microphone. To use this microphone, I need to turn on the phantom power switch on the back of the UVC-02. I will also turn up the mic knob to 12 o'clock to set the initial mic level. We will adjust this later. Next, I will connect a music player to the 1/8-inch aux audio input and turn up the aux knob to 12 o'clock as well. There is also an 1/8-inch connector for a headset with a built-in microphone, and you can use both the XLR and headset microphone inputs at the same time. In fact, you can combine audio from 5 different sources, which we will cover throughout this video. Let's go over what the audio mixer knobs are for. The mic knob controls the XLR input, and the phantom power switch is located in the center of the back panel. The H-mic knob controls the microphone part of a headset connected to the 1/8-inch headset input. The phones knob controls the headphones part of a connected headset, or standard headphones instead connected to that same input. The aux knob controls audio connected to the 1/8-inch aux input. This is great for playing music from your phone. The HDMI knob controls audio from your camera. For most setups, leave this turned all the way down. And the monitor out knob controls the 1/8-inch audio output, which can be used for audio speakers or a standalone audio recorder, like the RO7. Now that we have our sources connected, let's connect the UVC-02 to our computer with the included USB cable. The setup tool you installed earlier will open automatically when you connect it. You can disable this option in the software's tray icon if you prefer to open it manually. If there is an update for your UVC-02 firmware, the software will automatically ask if you want to update. This process takes about 1 minute. Make sure that you do not disconnect the USB cable during the update. When the update is complete, it'll ask you to disconnect and reconnect the USB cable. After that, it will ask if you want to keep your previous settings or restore the default settings. If you choose to restore, you have an option to back up your current settings to a file on your computer before restoring the default settings. But in most cases, you'll keep your previous settings. Any software that supports USB video and audio signals can use the UVC-02. Here are some examples. You can use Roland's free solutions like Roland Live Recorder and Roland Live Streamer for Windows, and Video Capture for VR for both Windows and Mac OS. Or you can use software like OBS Studio, conferencing solutions like Zoom and Teams, and you can even use web browser-based platforms. It's pretty open-ended. If using software like OBS Studio or Zoom, you have to manually select the UVC-02 as your video source and audio source separately. You should see your video at this point. If you do not, check the video status along the bottom of the UVC-02 setup tool. If the information in the box is red, the camera's current signal is not compatible. But don't worry, you just need to check the camera's instruction manual for information on how to output 1080p video. You can also search on YouTube for a video on how to set up your specific camera model's HDMI output. Also, if you see your camera's status information on screen in your streaming or recording software, you will need to disable it in your camera's settings. The UVC-02 does not display any information on top of your video signal. Now that we have working video, let's adjust our audio mix. For this, I am using the mic input, the aux input for my music player, and the phone's output for headphones. Simply adjust the knobs until you get a good audio level. Check the audio meters in the UVC-02 setup tool, making sure that the average level is in the yellow section of the meter. Note that there are also four audio sliders next to some of the meters. These are for audio inputs and outputs that do not have a knob on the UVC-02. You can use these sliders to adjust the audio level for imported sound effects, audio sent from the computer to the UVC-02 via USB, and audio sent to the computer from the UVC-02. When you test your audio and video, in most cases they will already be in sync, but you can adjust this if they are not. The easiest way to do this is to record a short video of a hand clap and some talking, and then watch it a few times. If there is a sync issue, in most cases the audio happens first. The UVC-02 setup tool lets you add delay to the entire audio mix to sync it to the video. On the left side, click the Others button, and then click the toggle button for USB out. The default value is 100 milliseconds, which is roughly 6 frames of video. Try another recording at that setting and watch it. The exact value will depend on your setup. For example, you may need to reduce it to 50 milliseconds and test again. While using it, note that the audio out, talk, and video out buttons are lit when active. You can press these buttons to mute audio and video. Pressing the audio out button will mute audio from the HDMI and aux inputs. Pressing the talk button will mute your mic and headset mic inputs. Later, we will show you how to customize this button. And pressing the video out button will cut to blank output. If no video source is connected or the camera settings need to be changed, the video out button will not light up until it receives a compatible signal. Also, the setup button will open and close the UVC-02 setup tool, and the effect button will disable any audio effects when it is not lit. You are now ready to start using your UVC-02, but let's dive deeper into the setup tool and go over its features. On the left side, there are additional menus. Let's start with System at the top. Here, you can change the color of your audio and video buttons, backup and restore your settings, and adjust the USB video format. Most setups should leave the format on the default quality setting. Next is the A button menu. Note that the symbols match the A1 and A2 buttons on the UVC-02, and you can set these up to do different things. Options include a voice changer for the mic and headset mic inputs, a reverb effect for the entire mix, sound effects playback from a file on your computer, and if you have a computer running Windows, PowerPoint slideshow control. Note that sound effects have to be 16-bit .wav files, up to 5 seconds long. You can also mix and match what the buttons do. For example, the A1 button can be a voice changer, and the A2 button can be a sound effect. There are several options for the voice changer via the drop-down menus. The mic and headset mic inputs each have their own voice change effect. To load your own sound effect, click the Change button. On the next screen, click File Open and choose your file on your computer. Then, click the Change Sound button to load it. This will take about 15 to 30 seconds. When finished, click OK, and you can return to the A button menu by clicking on the return arrow. With everything set up, press the A1 and A2 buttons on the UVC-02 to trigger those functions. For this next section, I will be switching over to the CGM30 gooseneck mic.
How is everybody doing? This is the voice changer effect on Gentlemen.
Moving on to the talk button menu, as mentioned earlier, you can change what the talk button does. The default setting toggles the mute function off and on, but you can change it so that you have to hold it down to either talk or mute the microphone. If you have a microphone with a high output, there is also an option in this menu to reduce the level by 20 decibels. This is similar to a pad switch that's available on some microphones. Next is the audio routing menu. Here are three templates for different applications, plus custom routing settings to the right of it. The first column lets you choose which audio inputs are sent to the USB output. The second column is for both the monitor and headphone outputs. The default settings are recommended for most setups. Be careful when making adjustments to avoid creating audio feedback or echo. The next three menus cover the audio effects. Let's start with the mic menu, which controls the XLR microphone input. For the rest of this section, I will switch over to the CGM30 microphone. I'll start with the effects button on the UVC-02 turned off. Along the top are three templates that are great for online meetings. These offer good starting points for noisy rooms, and you can still adjust each setting after loading a template. For this section, I will select Clear Voice and press the effect button on the UVC-02 to enable it. Let's start with the noise suppressor, which reduces background noise. If you find that your room is too noisy after turning off fans and closing doors and windows, this feature can help. You can adjust the amount of removal with the slider control. Note that the higher settings may affect the quality of your voice. Also note that video conferencing software like Zoom has its own noise and echo cancellation, so you can choose whether to use those effects on the UVC-02 or the video conferencing software. The de-esser reduces harsh S sounds, and you can adjust how much it removes with the slider control. Here's an example. The EQ or equalizer lets you adjust low, mid, and high frequencies with a visual of what the adjustments look like. This is with the EQ turned off, and now I'm going to turn it back on and make some adjustments. I'm going to open up the low filter and the high filter. And for the bands here, I can make additional adjustments to the frequencies. And the expander and compressor help control your mic's audio levels automatically. The expander smoothly reduces audio levels below the target threshold, and the compressor reduces levels above the threshold. So this is with the expander turned on, this is with the expander turned off, and this is with the compressor turned on. And again, you can make adjustments to the effect using these controls. If you're not familiar with using EQ and compression, start with the templates and make adjustments from there. Turn these settings on and off to compare the change in sound until you're happy with the results. Also note that the H mic menu gives you the same options, but for the headset mic. And finally, there's the Others effects menu, which has a number of useful audio tools. The echo canceller is helpful if you're not using headphones. Remember from earlier that video conferencing platforms like Zoom already have their own version of this, and you'll want to choose which one you want to use. If you're using the USB input audio from your computer, USB in high cut eliminates high frequencies if the incoming audio sounds harsh or overly bright. You can adjust the frequency using the slider. All frequencies above that number are cut out. This setting only affects USB input audio and not the USB output to the computer. The ducker is a helpful tool when playing background music. If I have a music player connected to the aux input, and when this is enabled, audio from the mic and headset mic inputs will lower the HDMI, aux, and/or USB input level while talking. I will now switch over to the CGM30 microphone so you can hear the ducking effect. So I'm going to start by turning the ducker off and then playing some music. And so obviously the music's playing at a level where it's a little hard to hear me. So I'm going to turn on the ducker and you're going to hear the music drop. The level's set to negative 36, but I can increase that if I want it to kind of sit under me at a higher level there. So you can hear me talking, you can sort of hear the music as well. And then in addition to that, the mic sensitivity is gonna set at which point this triggers. So when you turn the sensitivity up, it's harder to get the ducker to kick in versus all the way down here where it's almost always on. And then the hold time is the higher the hold time, the longer it stays at that lower level. So you notice that I stopped talking and it's gradually trying to come back up versus when you bring it way down, it's going to come in and out quickly. So you want to probably set the hold at between 5 and 7 maybe. And then the sensitivity is going to depend on your voice and your mic levels. And then you adjust the level setting to taste. So depending on where you want the music to sit while you're talking. Anti-feedback helps prevent your microphone audio from squealing if you accidentally create an audio loop with your audio routing settings or connected speaker system. If your UVC-02 monitor out is connected to speakers, a good general tip is to keep them as far away from the microphone as possible. Output auto leveler is similar to a compressor and can help if your audio mix is not consistently loud enough during your test. I will once again switch over to the CGM30 microphone so that you can hear the leveler effect. Okay, so I'm going to start by playing the music. And I have the level set with the aux knob, so I'm not using the ducker in this situation. So now I'm going to turn on the output auto leveler and you can hear the different settings. So you can hear right away that the music level went up a bit. So the sensitivity with which the leveler engages is right now at, when it goes over negative 12 dB. So I can make it less sensitive by increasing that so it doesn't engage as much. Or I can bring it all the way down, and of course you hear my audio fluctuating a lot because it's going over that negative 30 dB. So I'm going to bring this up here, and hold time, the longer hold time, the effect's going to sound more natural. And if you bring it all the way down, you're going to hear more fluctuations as it goes between turning the leveler on and off. So what you can do is adjust to taste. You're probably going to use some higher settings for that feature. And the output delay we covered earlier in this video when discussing audio sync. You can apply separate delays to the USB output and the monitor and phone's outputs. That concludes this tutorial on Roland Pro AV's UVC-02 web presentation dock. We hope that this video answers all your questions and has you up and running. But if you have additional questions, please visit roland.com/backstage, register your UVC-02, and submit a support ticket. We'll be happy to help. Thank you for watching.